Perception is everything. Which is farther west? Don't look at a map, just think about it. Los Angeles or San Francisco? Which of those two places do you think is further west? How about Los Angeles or Santa Barbara? Los Angeles or Reno, Nevada? Perception is everything. Let's look. Okay, if we look at the map on the left side, you can see those four red arrows are indicating those four cities: Los Angeles, Santa Barbara, San Francisco, Reno. If you look at the map on the right side, the map on the right side has lines of longitude. And remember, what's going to happen is you count with longitude 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on up to 180, and this is in the Western Hemisphere. So as you go on that map from right to left, so you're headed left, that is further west on that map. Okay, let's check it out. That red arrow on the map on the right-hand side is pointing at Los Angeles. The bronze arrow is pointing at San Francisco. These purple lines are lines of longitude. So you can see as we go further to the left, which is to the west, San Francisco is to the west of Los Angeles. Now the bronze arrow is pointing at Santa Barbara. Santa Barbara, now you can tell, is also further west than Los Angeles. Are you wondering about Reno now? Are you rethinking Reno? There's Reno. These are the lines of longitude. Reno, Nevada is actually to the west of Los Angeles, California. How about that? The things you learn in this class. Perception is everything. One last thing, we need to do some math. That's right, I know, but we can do it. When you stand at the edge of the ocean, I was actually doing this yesterday in Long Beach. When you stand at the edge of the ocean and you watch a ship sailing out to sea, how far away from you does the ship get before it begins to go over the horizon and then eventually disappear over the horizon? Have you ever stood at the coast in Southern California and looked out at Catalina Island? If you had a telescope, can you see Avalon? Have you noticed if you're right at the coast on a clear day that Catalina Island actually looks like two islands because there's that dip in the middle? Catalina is 26 miles away from Southern California, from Long Beach or Huntington Beach, when you look out. Is Catalina partly over the horizon? The Earth, of course, is curved. It's a spherical object. Take a look at those two ships, especially the one on the left. Is it sinking? No, neither of those ships are sinking. They're just over the horizon, at least partly. So how far out do you look into the ocean before something begins to sail over the horizon? Well, there's a formula. You can see part of it involves square root. The formula works like this. K in this formula equals distance in miles to the horizon. In other words, how far out you look before something begins to go over the horizon and eventually disappear. H is the height of your eyes above the ground. Do you know how far your eyes are above the ground? How many feet above the ground your eyes are? And the formula is this: K, which is distance in miles to the horizon, equals 1.317 times the square root of H. So the formula would also look like this: K equals 1.317 times square root of H. Do the square root part first, then multiply by 1.317. So in other words, let's assume that your eyes are 4 feet off the ground. If your eyes are 4 feet above the ground, you would take 4 and do the square root of it. So put into your calculator 4, then square root. That's going to give you a number. Then multiply by 1.317. And what that's going to do is it's going to tell you how many miles the horizon is away from your eyes. So in other words, how far out it is before that ship begins to sail over the horizon. And that answer you're going to get is going to be in miles.